any state seek any help from Keith Vaz beyond this? Did you offer any hospitality to Keith Vaz?
None.
Is it true that Keith Vaz was invited to where we are today here in Montenegro?
I know for a fact he had never been to Montenegro.
So you're saying no hospitality ever given by you,
Mr.
no financial
Vaz.
Benefits that you've ever passed
I
on
had
to Keith Vaz?
I had one dinner with Mr. Keith Vaz and he paid for it. So there is no hospitality given by me. In fact, he paid for my dinner too.
Can I also ask you, you mentioned Vasundhara Raje, and you said that Vasundhara Raje went with your wife, in fact, for cancer treatment in 2012-13. What is your relationship with Vasundhara? Now documents which have come out show that she was actually a witness when you wanted your British residency
That's
in 2011-12.
My relationship with Vasundhara Raje goes back 30 years. That relationship is known to everybody. So there's no point speculating that. She's a close friend of the family and has been of my wife for a long period of time, since we've been married. And has been very close to us. It is known in media. She's been pictured with me everywhere. And it's been seen with my wife.
So she volunteered openly to be a witness for your residency, or you asked her to do so?
No, she openly agreed to be. But she, unfortunately, by the time the thing went to trial, she was already chief minister. So she could not come for being a witness. So the statements she gave is on record in the courts, and which will be
that between 2003 and 8, when she was chief minister, you were very close to her, and were handling a lot of her projects and
I
deals.
Was not handling any projects or deal with her. I was close to her.
You remember there was the entire Haveli controversy which you were charged later by the Congress government.
Again, why do we come back to the Congress government? We always come back to the Congress government, right? Why don't we go to the facts? Congress government has an agenda. I don't have an agenda. And the Haveli thing is no Haveli thing. I bought an Haveli legally.
You bought?
What is
a question mark.
Irrespective, what has Haveli got to do with it?
Did you use your relationships with Sushma Swaraj and Vasundhara Raje for your advantage while you were in London, yes or no?
No, I did not. I used them for making sure that my wife gets treated, and that is all. And only at the last resort, when I had won in every court, and it was being delayed on grounds, only being delayed on grounds of records being created by the UPA government against me to clarify that the UPA government is no longer there. I said, why don't you check with the current government, to the UK government, that my case is not the same.
So you believe that the UPA government was carrying out a political vendetta and the NDA government simply corrected what you believe was that vendetta being carried out earlier?
That's correct.
What you're saying.
That is right.
Having said that, you also have said that Sushma Swaraj therefore has no reason to resign. In fact, you say the wrong people are being asked to resign.
That's right.
Who are the people then you believe who should be resigning?
The people I believe that should be resigning are the people who have hid across borders the fact of the secret conspiracy. They are the ones who should be resigning.
Who is targeting Sushma Swaraj then?
I do not know. You should know very well.
I'll tell you why I'm asking you this. Because you have had a difficult relationship with Arun Jaitley, the finance minister. In fact, in a series of tweets in 2013, you repeatedly targeted him. He was also on the other side of the battle in the BCCI. Do you believe that Mr. Jaitley has any role in this?
I do not know. I cannot comment about Mr. Jaitley's role in this. I have no reason to believe either way, one way or the other. And I'd rather refrain from saying anything in this matter because I do not know, truly, who is behind this. All I know for a matter of fact is that somebody may have hacked into Mr. Vaz's emails, and that's how the matter has come into light. The issue is
whether. Who hacked into those emails?
I do not know.
Suddenly, I was told one of your employees could have hacked into your emails.
No. I don't think that
so
is.
So you believe somebody hacked into.
Nobody has hacked into my email.
Can I ask you, though?
Yes.
And let's turn to facts.
Yes.
The facts is that the Sunday Times the fact is that for you have many charges pending against you in India. At the moment.
Let's go to Sunday Times issue, okay?
Why
is the Sunday Times going after me? I'll tell you why.
Tell me
why. And this is a bigger issue.
Tell me why.
Who owns the Sunday Times? Tell me.
Rupert Murdoch.
What is Rupert Murdoch and connection with IPL and BCCI?
Are you now bringing a BCCI IPL angle to you?
Without doubt. Because I'll tell you right now, I'll tell you the angle. I'll tell you the angle. The Champions League T20, which is a contract that I signed with the BCCI, which is a multi-billion-dollar contract, which has no exit clauses for 10 years, right? Mr. Murdoch has personally asked me in the past to find a way to get out of those contracts. Mr. Murdoch had asked me many times, and Mr. Manu Sahni, who was the CEO, if there's an exit. I said, there is no exit. From now to the next 3 years, the payment on account of those contracts is in the region of $800 million. Now, why, when there is no exit clause and there is no documentation that allows that agreement to be cancelled, is all of a sudden being cancelled? is the question, and they didn't want
you
me to
have
talk
no,
about
it. You today have no real role today in the I true sense of the word in the BCCI. So why should Murdoch be targeting you?
Because I am going to be going out there and targeting, saying that the exit clauses for 10 years is not possible.
So you believe Rupert Murdoch in some way in the Sunday Times is behind this entire...
Without doubt.
Is the reason why the Sunday Times is going for you?
By the way, Rajdeep, have I ever made a statement to you now or in the past, years in advance of the controversy ever coming out, telling you this controversy will come out and why it'll come out, and I've always been proven right?
You know,
because of the reason that I do my research and I do not drop names for the sake of dropping names.
You do drop names, and
yes,
you have dropped a name just now, but I dropped many names in the past, and I'm going to come back to some of those big names.
The fact is that
there are charges against you, including money laundering. The enforcement directorate wants to investigate you in cases amounting to 700 to 800 crores in connection with the IPL of 2009 and 2010.
One second.
We are now
in the
Haveli case, they want to investigate you. My question to you.
Hold on.
Why don't you appear before the ED?
Why don't you go to India?
Why would I take
the risk of going to India when I have a security concern? Why should I?
What if I say that the security concern is completely exaggerated? There is an NDA government, they will promise you complete security.
It has got nothing to do with the government. You give me complete peace of mind that somebody is not going to take a pot shot, I will be happy. But point is this, it has been examined cross-sectionally by the UK courts and the Indian courts. I have been told very clearly, the judgments have come on that basis. If you have not bothered to read the judgments, I'm afraid...
There are judgments, but the fact is that ED says they still want to investigate you. Blue corner notice. You say there is no blue corner notice. Your lawyer yesterday put out a statement by the Secretary General of the Interpol saying that there is no... I have seen that there is no blue corner notice.
I can only comment...
ED sources tell us that they have been...
Tell them to produce it. No, I produced the letter. Let them produce it.
So
if you say that ED sources say... I am going by facts.
Sir.
Okay, now one second.
Mr. Modi, if you are not a proclaimed offender, if you are not an absconder with no blue corner notice, why don't you return then back to India?
Again, I keep telling you, Rajdeep, why don't you listen? If somebody is listening, then only you listen.
Yes.
My point is very clear that I am not returning back for security concern. When somebody says I have a corner notice against me, there must be a document to show that. Mm-hmm. If I am showing a document that's saying there isn't, if somebody says, according to my sources, who are these sources? According to my sources, Lalit Modi has done this. According to my sources, Lalit Modi has absconded. According to my sources, Lalit Modi is a fraud. Or Lalit Modi XYZ. According to whose sources? Tell me. Give me the source. Give me the document. According to which court
have I disbanded? You know that the committee of the BCCI, which was appointed...
Listen.
Indicted you for several financial...
Who was the chairman of that committee?
...irregularities, including Jyotiraditya Scindia was the chairman of the committee. It also included...
No. Hold on, sorry.
It included Arun Jaitley as well. Arun Jaitley was there.
One second.
So was Jyotiraditya Scindia.
I want to correct you here. Mr. Jyotiraditya Scindia was not chairman of the committee. Mr. Arun Jaitley was
Arun Jaitley was chairman and Jyotiraditya Scindia was a member.
Hold on.
Indicted you for...
Can I just interrupt you?
Yes.
That committee didn't have the decency to let me come on air. The day I was supposed to come on air and go on to trial with them, the video conference, that's the day they decided to end the committee. So what is a committee that does not allow the accused to appear before it? What banana republic is this? Tell me that the committee that is pronouncing judgment on me is not allowing the witness to appear before it. It takes all the other witnesses. When it's time for me as the last witness to come in, and myself, I am the defender.
Mm-hmm.
If I am not allowed to come in front of the committee and make my say, and they decide that very day, oh, time's running out, we are going to pass the judgment
Can I just respond to that?
Yes.
The fact is that all this is in connection with the manner in which the IPL was shifted out of South Africa, and there are allegations in that of foreign exchange irregularities. Just a minute.
Yes.
In the context of that, those decisions that you were took led eventually in April 2010 for them to appoint this committee. You leave the country a month later.
The presumption, therefore, is that you were the only person singled out.
Do you believe that that entire process was N. Srinivasan, the former BCCI chief, also part of it? Was Arun Jaitley also part of these decision makings that allegedly led to allegations of financial irregularities?
Okay, let me clear the fact now.
Yes.
First and foremost, this committee was so afraid to be appointed when I was present. It was only appointed after I left the country.
Mm-hmm.
It was appointed in June of 2010.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, after I left in May 2010. Mm-hmm. Secondly, the members that you so mentioned in this committee that were part of the BCCI. Yes, Mr. Jaitley was part of the committee. Mr. Jaitley was also part of the process of moving it to South Africa. So was Mr. Srinivasan as part of the process. So was Mr. Jyoti Rajesh Sindhya. So was Mr. Pawar of that committee. By the way, I wasn't the only decision maker. I was just a member of that committee. The decision was taken by the committee.
So you're saying that if there are foreign exchange irregularities discovered in the context of that, because remember they also included allegation of embezzling $80 million
we'll
in a television deal.
But the fact is
you're saying that if you were being questioned, you believe everyone else also should have been questioned, whether it's Mr. Srinivasan or whether it's Arun Jaitley. Is that what you're saying?
Number one. Number two.
That what you're saying?
I'm saying yes. Number one. Number two. First and foremost, the decision to move to South Africa was a joint decision. Mm-hmm. I happen to be the chairman and I happen to be the face. So be it. And I take my responsibility. Mm-hmm. When it comes down to the ED notices, and yes, I'm a respondent to the ED notices. By the way, your office has a copy of my reply. They didn't bother to even read it. It was sent years ago of my reply to ED, where I said the BCCI was wrong in the way they operated the financial accounts in South Africa. I've gone on record on ED. And by the way, that is the basis of what the ED has penalized the BCCI for 1600 crore. It is my reply. It is my reply to the ED, which says very clearly that Shashank Manohar proposed that the BCCI should open accounts in South Africa subject to Reserve Bank of India approval. I seconded that. Yes. By the way, 1 second, it's very important because you keep bringing up this issue and this is a major issue in terms of the ED. Nobody understands. I have provided all the documents and we're ready to provide again. I was excluded by Mr. Srinivasan's office in that financial process. He said, you stay out of it in writing. I am deciding how the bank accounts will be operated and I will decide how the money will be transferred. He made a committee. 1 second. And this is the core connection. He made a committee and he decided not to take Reserve Bank of India's approval and decided on that basis to transfer money out. I had no role to play in that and I have shown clearly in my documentations to that effect.
Can I ask you though?
Yes.
You've had close relations over these years with several politicians. You've admitted today your close relationship with Sushma Swaraj and family, with Vasundhara Raje. You've had close relations with Sharad Pawar,
yes,
whom you've also thanked in the note.
Yes.
With Praful Patel.
Yes.
With Rajiv Shukla.
Yes.
Did you at any stage seek their help in all these years or not?
Yes, I seek their help all the time, but they were helpless. They could not provide me anything.
Between 2009 and 2013,
yes,
when Rajiv Shukla, Sharad Pawar, Patel were part of the UPA government, did you seek their help to get these travel documents?
Yes.
The same help that you sought from Sushma Swaraj, and what was their response?
They tried very hard, but
Sushma Swaraj succeeded.
One second.
My point. So
my
Sushma
point is
Swaraj,
not that. My point is very simple. But
Sushma
please understand.
Swaraj used her position to benefit you. They
again,
did not.
No, they did. Please
they
understand.
They tried.
They tried very hard. Who was the person opposing it? It was that private office of the government in India communicating
it
with the UK.
It was Mr. Chidambaram, because Mr. Chidambaram wanted you to appear before the Enforcement Directorate in India. He wanted you deported.
No. Mr. Chidambaram wanted to take out his political vendetta for me moving the IPL in 2009 to 2000 to South Africa, and everybody knows that. The fact, and for Shashi Tharoor's episode, that is the political agenda.
Salman Khurshid, former External Affairs Minister, told us that you did send feelers to the UPA seeking help for your passport and travel documents. But the fact is that you were also refusing to join the investigations in India.
Very wrong. I guess he wanted me to come to India. I said my security risk. I'm saying that today even. I said very clearly, like I said,
You keep saying the security risk, yet during the 2010 IPL, you were freely roaming around in the security risk, which you claim has dated back to 2009.
I'm not
so
saying,
in 2010, you had no problem staying in India.
One second.
Only when the cases start coming
one
close
second,
to you that you decide to leave
Radeep,
India.
Radeep, I left India the day my security cover was pulled. If the government of India at that point in time was so belligerent and decided that my security was a huge issue, why would they pull my security cover? This is not a distorted fact. This is the fact which has been recognized, investigated, fought by the UK government in court. It has been recorded, it has been investigated, and the courts have ruled not once, three times in that favor on this particular issue itself.
Can I?
Now, on this particular issue itself, they have ruled. I know you're being fed back by your what
no,
question
I'm
was.
No, I'm not.
My
I'm
point,
not at all. No, hold on. I have done my research today. I'm going to ask you this.
Yes, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm going to ask you this very clearly. Today, all that you're telling me, effectively none of these individuals who has come out openly in your support in the past because you are close to them. I've seen photographs of you with all of them.
Yes.
Today you are seen as a PNG effectively by many of them, as a touch me not for this political class. Is that because you in your brash way have targeted too many of them in the past? Nobody wants to openly identify with you today.
I only target people.
Even Vasundhara Raja has distanced herself from you today.
You may say so, whatever you say. My point is very simple. I have never gone out of my way to target somebody. When somebody targets me, I sit back and take all the targets. What happens when they target me? Am I supposed to just sit back, roll over and die like Sunanda did? No. I am the one that is going to stand up for my rights and fight. I have not run away. I have fought in every court. I've gone out there and I'm sitting here today with you. And I'm happy to go out and tell everything. I'm happy to put the documentation out. I am not the type to run away. I'm not the type. But yes, I will not take a bullet for you. Forget it. It ain't happening.
You've been at war with N. Srinivasan for years.
Excuse me. And then what happened?
Is there a Srinivasan angle also to this entire episode that we are seeing?
I do not know.
You're now blaming Rupert Murdoch.
I'm not saying you can take. There are lots of.
Because I am
interest.
Told there's speculation that you were spying on Srinivasan and he in turn was spying on you.
It doesn't make a difference to me whether he was spying on me. I wasn't spying on him. I get information on him all the time. And by the way, whatever information I got was given to everybody. So the point is, you use that information, all you channeled use the information, and what I said was right. And in 2010, when I started saying these things, and I said the empire fixing is taking place, and that's the reason my fight with Srinivasan began. And you all said, I'm making it up. Srinivasan said, I'm making it up. And everybody believed, because you were all ready to get accreditation and go into the matches. Everybody played the role of Srinivasan and said, he's God. And I was wrong. I am sorry.
Lalit Modi,
I have taken enough from everybody. I am not the type to sit back and roll over and cry.
You keep saying that. And in fact, yesterday before Mr. Abdi's press conference,
yes,
your lawyer's, you said, await explosive material.
Yes, you have given it to
me. You even said, hold on. You even said Shashi Tharoor, P. Chidambaram.
I'm telling you right
Salman
now.
Salman Khurshid, be warned. My point is, your.
I have just given you the explosive material.
Many believe that the press conference turned out to be a damn squib.
Listen, the press conference is one thing. The document.
Because you keep threatening people.
Rajdeep.
Dropping names.
Rajdeep.
But where is the hard evidence?
I've given it to you. What the hell?
The hard evidence is that they say. I'll tell you.
One second.
They were deliberately blocking your residency permit.
Their argument
is that you should return to India. Listen.
If that is the case, why didn't they use it in the court? Why did they go and arm twist somebody? My issue is not that. If they believe that I should be coming back legally, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then legally press the legal button, right? Why not go to the legal route? When they are in court, government of India are defending themselves against me, right? How do I win? I win because the courts ruled that I was right. So when you say, I say, you say, forget all of this.
Sources say,
forget all of that. The issue is,
they told me yesterday that Lalit Modi had also made efforts to, in some way, snuggle up to the British establishment, and many people within the British establishment, you were desperately wooing them because you wanted your residency permit. Did you extend hospitality to them as well?
No, nobody.
Extended no hospitality. Let me get this clear. No hospitality to Vasundhara Raja between 29 and 14.
No
hospitality to Sushma Swaraj.
None
to her husband.
None
to any of our family members.
None at all.
At no stage.
Nobody.
And no one in the British establishment. No
not
Keith Vaz. You've never ever taken them on holiday. Never offered any of them benefits. So
no
they, on their own, Vasundhara Raja has come forward and benefited you. Sushma Swaraj
on her own volition has come and benefited you.
She knew your controversial past, and yet as External Affairs Minister, she goes ahead and benefits
one
you.
One second. This is a matter of life and death. You all make it into another issue. Huh? Of course, if somebody is close to us, and somebody has is going through a serious medical issue, and of course they will do everything that they can to sort out if there's something wrong. Listen, again we keep coming back to the same issue. I could have got a travel document, a passport from anybody. I could have got from any place I wanted. The issue is very simple. I did not choose to do so. You don't understand the fact that I fought it.
How many times did you ring up Sushma Swaraj seeking her help
once
for this travel? Only one phone call?
One phone call. Why do I need to charge? I did not want to use it, but it was a last resort issue. When it came to an issue, when it came down to the facts under the Right to Information Act, that I came to know in writing from the UK government that the only reason that they're stopping it, not for any other reason, which I would have got anyway a few days later, but the timing was critical for me.
Haven't you ended up compromising her position as External
Affairs
Minister?
No, I have not. I have not compromised anybody's position. What she has done is a brave thing to go out of the way to correct what was being wrongly being done to me. And by the way, a few days later, the Indian courts have justified and given me the pass. You don't want to commend the person for that. No, you want to pick up.
And there was no appeal against that in the Supreme Court.
But there was no reason to appeal because I've won everywhere. It was a slamming dunk order. I've got also cost paid by the UK government. Point in time when you're talking about this, it has taken 5 years to get to something like that. So justice was only provided to me for 5 years. What about the suffering I've had for 5 years? So you keep talking about that. Who's going to pay for that?
You say suffering. That's an interesting word you use because over the last few years, you've also lived a very luxurious life. In fact, in the last week, you've traveled to Cuba, you've traveled to Venice. Listen, now you're here in Montenegro. Can I ask you this? Who pays for your lifestyle? This opulent lifestyle that you lead?
Go and look at what Modi Enterprises is worth. Then talk to me about it. Go to that and just check.
Has your lifestyle changed in any way as a result?
My lifestyle has become less than what it used to be in the past. So be very clear about that. That I come from a background and I run companies which are involved, which have multi-billion-dollar turnover and profits.
Your financial dealings, transparent, open?
Completely transparent. And there is no issues about it. And there has not been a single people to pick on it. My lifestyle hasn't been
born out. It's been picked on in India.
Because you choose to pick on it. You make it sound like
that. It's not me. It's not the media. It's the agencies who picked it up. Was the Rajasthan government when the Congress government picked it up?
Where was Rajasthan government? My grandfather.
The CBI, the enforcement director. I know you come from a very, very respected family.
My lifestyle cannot be financed by cricket. My lifestyle is of my own. It is my working and my family's working that has caused my lifestyle. It is well known. We have one of the biggest companies and we have done so proudly and we are one of the largest taxpayers in the country. Huh? So we have no issues about that. And so when somebody goes out there and starts to attack the credibility, they are looking at the wealth I've created for the VCCI. Yes, I created 47,000 crores wealth for VCCI. And it is because I was going and trying to protect that wealth of the VCCI and some politician trying to eat it through this state association is where the problem began.
Do you have any regrets?
No regrets at all.
And the manner in which today you find yourself.
Do I look like a person I have regrets? Do I look like a person who have regrets? I'm living life to the fullest because I have done nothing wrong. I'm not hiding under the bench.
You've been far too brash. Made too many enemies and therefore cannot even return to your own country.
I can return anytime I want, but I will not take a chance on my life, number one. And number two, there is nothing on this planet that can stop me from telling the truth. Truth ultimately surfaces, and I have said that day one. And it has surfaced today, it has surfaced in Srinivasan's case, it has surfaced in BCCI's case, it has surfaced all along. I can't be hidden. I live in a glass palace, I know, and everybody can see through it. So I know people are going to throw stones. If you allow the stones to hit you, you'll get buried. I have been buried, I've risen, and I've bided my time. But every time I have said something 3 years before, it has come out
and
to be true.
And along the way, while you keep getting buried and rising, different others are getting collateral damage along the way. The latest being, as I said, Sushma Swaraj and Vasundhara Raje.
Unfortunate that the media likes to play it like that instead of commending them for what they have done and penalizing the people who bought wrong, like the Congress Party and Mr. Chidambaram. They are the ones who should be paying the price and saying, look what you did to a person wrongfully done, which had the UK courts have ended up because supporting him. UK government has ended up paying a fine to me because of listening to Mr. Chidambaram.
Mr. Lalit Modi, as always, you're feisty.